Heart valve disease is when one or more of your heart valves in your heart doesn't work properly. There are four valves in the heart. These valves include the tricuspid, the mitral, the pulmonary valve, and the aortic valve. And they're like little doors that open and close and keep blood flowing in the one direction. Now, these valves can become stuck closed and cause stenosis, or these valves can leak. Heart valve disease increases really exponentially as we get older. Maybe there are 1 in 50 patients under the age of 60 who have heart valve disease. By the time you get to 75, that's 1 in 6. These conditions can be conditions that were present at birth or congenital, or they can be conditions that have been acquired through the course of patients' lives. Lifestyle factors can lead to valvular heart disease. There are infections in use, such as rheumatic fever, that also lead to heart valve disease. So it's a common condition, and it's increasing in our population as we age. Well, some of the more common symptoms are breathlessness, reduced exercise capacity. Patients may get chest pain, chest tightness, discomfort in the chest, arm, or back. They may get symptoms of presyncope, where they feel giddy, lightheaded. Some patients may even pass out. Palpitations that result from arrhythmia. So you may feel your heart beating in an irregular or erratic fashion. All these can be symptoms of heart valve disease. There are a number of things we can do to manage heart valve disease. That is not limited to some lifestyle factors, which including stopping smoking, managing blood pressure, regular exercise, a healthy diet. Beyond lifestyle factors, there are other important things that we can do. The doctor's very important in assessing and evaluating the extent of your heart valve disease at baseline, and then following and monitoring that valve disease over time. Medication can control symptoms, and it's important to have compliance with medical therapy recommended by your doctor. So a common condition is aortic stenosis, and this is where the aortic valve becomes calcified and doesn't open and close well. Over time, it strangles blood flow to the body. Breathlessness, chest pain, dizziness, all result. TAVI is a new treatment where the valve is replaced by a small catheter placed in the groin, and this obviates the need for open heart surgery. There is quicker recovery and less complications. Even more common than aortic valve disease is mitral valve disease. The mitral valve typically becomes leaky, and this again causes symptoms like breathlessness, ankle swelling, reduced exercise capacity. Traditionally, this is repaired or replaced with open surgery. Increasingly, we are able to also repair this through a small incision in the groin via a transcatheter device called a mitral. So you've had your surgery or your minimally invasive operation or your transcatheter valve replacement. And how long do you need to recover now? Well, it's going to depend on what kind of therapy you've had, whether you've had a transcatheter procedure or open surgery. The quickest recovery is associated with the transcatheter procedures. You're up and around within hours and home in days. With open surgery, it takes a bit longer, maybe 7 to 10 days to get over the operation and some months in rehabilitation to recover from the surgery. Your doctor's going to be in the best position to tell you which kind of treatment is most suitable for you.